Hello everyone, welcome to my review of the DeWalt Tstak Connect radio and charger. The Tstak Connect weighs about 15 pounds. It's not light, but it's not heavy. It's actually very easily lifted by one arm. Very portable. Now, first thing you'll notice when you're looking at this Tstak Connect is the armor cladding on all the corners. Very rugged. The handle feels very sturdy also. I mean, there's no movement in it at all. The controls are nicely recessed. And there's a nice gap beneath the unit, a half an inch or so, to keep it up out of the dirt and the grime. Let's power this unit up and see. Let's see what kind of features it has. Now, the Tstak can be powered in two different ways. One is with the supplied AC adapter system. Comes with the unit. And the other is the optional lithium ion battery that DeWalt makes. And of course, if you have the tools, you already have the battery. So let's plug it up. Now you'll notice that the plug adapter is on the bottom of the unit beneath this access plate, this access cover, I should say. So let's plug into the receptacle. And I'm sure the reason that it's located down here is to keep it from being exposed to moisture, rain and or splashing liquids of one sort or another. And that clearance that we talked about a minute ago works quite nicely with that to keep that cable from being pinched. Now let's plug it in. And turn it on. And you'll see that all the controls are backlit. And we also get the nice LCD display. I believe it's just two colors, yellow and black. Let's move the Tstak into a different orientation, a horizontal orientation, to make these controls a little easier to read. And you'll notice the display rotated with the orientation of the unit. Very nice feature. Okay, so what we have here is the home key, the back key, forward and reverse. So let's press the home key to see what modes are available to us. And right away we see we have FM, AM, Bluetooth, auxiliary, and settings. Let's try the FM
Gainesville's classic
feature first.
100.9.
You don't want to clean your
And you
room.
Notice that we immediately have a radio comes on.
Dusting.
We can scan between stations by
work.
Oh. You'll notice over here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those are presets. If I had loaded them previously, we could just press one of these buttons and we could go to that preset station. It's actually a little bit too time consuming right now to show you how to do that, but just be aware that that feature is available. Okay, we're in auto tune, so we go to the next channel by simply pressing and holding the forward arrow.
Okay, Jimmy Allen. He was on us.
Very simple, very easy to move between the stations. And you'll notice that we're getting text information along with the band indication. Now what that is digital information that is now being transmitted along with your normal FM radio frequencies. And this radio happens to have a decoder that allows it to display that text information or digital information. Very nice feature. Okay, so let's say we don't like the tone of the music that we're listening to. We can simply go to settings, sound, and we can adjust bass, treble, and mid-range. Nice feature, handy, just like the old days with the knobs for your old FM radios. We never had a mid-range though, I don't think. All right, back to home. Let's go to AM. And let's see if we can find a station. And we may or may not be able to do that because, oh, there we go. I was going to say because we have, we're actually under a tin roof. But it does seem to be working. Now, if we momentarily press the round volume knob here, we can select between manual tune and auto tune. And this works for FM too. So if we select manual, we should be able to turn this knob and manually select different frequencies that hopefully we think we have a radio station on. But we already know that we only have one station available at 850 for this particular location. And it's going to take forever to get there. Let's see, 620, 80, 710... 8, 30, 40, 50. So you can either auto scan or you can manually tune. Alright, so let's go back to home and let's examine this auxiliary feature. If we select that, we get a cable graphic connector, and the reason for that is if we open this center cabinet here, we have two connectors available to us. One is the auxiliary input, and the other one is the USB interface. The auxiliary input allows us to use the standard 2.5 millimeter plug system that lets you connect. Plug into the headphone receptacle on your smart device, and let's see here. And allows you to play music through the auxiliary cable. Let's see if we go to another. So if your device does not have a Bluetooth interface, you can use this auxiliary hookup to stream your music with. Now, another nice feature here that USB plug that we just looked at allows you to keep your phone charged or your streaming device charged while it's hooked up to the Tstak Connect. It's a very nice feature for older music devices that may or may not have Bluetooth. Okay, so Can stop that. Disconnect all of this. And let's move on to the feature that makes this a Bluetooth receiver. And we do that, we go home, we go to Bluetooth. And lo and behold, it's looking to be paired with my streaming device. If I select OK, we are connected. And then from there, I can stream music from my smartphone device. Let's say we don't like that song, we can go to the next one. Or even the next one. The point is you can go anywhere in your library that you would like to go. And or you still have control over it with your smart device too. Let's say you're on the job site and you want to keep your phone within a reason, well, close proximity to the Bluetooth receiver. You can just lock it up in the cabinet and now you've got an integrated streaming music system. Okay. So let's see how the battery system works on this device. Alright, so we'll momentarily turn it off. And unplug the AC adapter. And you'll notice in the same compartment that we had our auxiliary and USB connector availability, we also have the battery plug-in. And we're going to just set this in that cavity, push it forward, and you'll hear it click, and it locked right in. Very simple. So now we should be able to turn the unit on again, and we are now being powered by the battery. And if we stream our music once again, let's see here. Let's go home, Bluetooth, and let's make sure that we're still connected here. There we go. So now we're running on battery power. And if we turn the unit off and we reconnect the AC adapter, You'll notice that we get two indicators on the main display. One is a little red lamp next to the plug that indicates we're on AC power, and you see the flashing green lamp next to the battery indicates that we're charging. We're now charging this battery that's been plugged into the connector down here. So, very nice setup, very versatile, very rugged, strong, and very nice sounding stereo system. We turn it on. Unfortunately, one drawback, there it goes. I was gonna say that it doesn't always connect to the Bluetooth, but there was no problem at all. My bad. Well, that concludes our review of the DeWalt Tstak Connect Radio and Charger. I hope that I've been helpful. And thank you very much for watching. Bye now.